Did you know what Fidel Castro loved most from India? Moringa, also known as drumsticks, Sajne, Murungai and Nogekai. He called the plant the miracle from India and credited it for his recovery from a long illness. He had got his aides to bring him Moringa seeds from South India and had them cultivated for his daily diet after being told they are good for stomach ailments. In fact, when he finally recovered, Castro's first public meeting was a discussion on drumsticks, where he explained how it was the only plant to have all amino acids. In fact, it has been found that Moringa contains more than 92 nutrients, 46 types of antioxidants and 36 anti-inflammatory agents. A serving of fresh Moringa leaves has more vitamin A than found in 4 carrots and more vitamin C than 7 oranges. But much before modern medicine discovered this hardy miracle plant, India's Ayurveda and Siddha medicines were propounding its benefits. Which is why Moringa has been a kitchen staple in many parts of India for centuries. Almost every part of the tree is edible. The leaves cook down into a slightly bitter stir-fry. Its delicate white flowers come apart when simmered in sambar. The ribbed pods are eaten in an assortment of curries. Its root and bark, though less popular in cooking, have medicinal properties. So as a drought-resilient supply of nutrition security, Moringa may hold the key to surviving the hotter, drier days to come. Interestingly, given the ability it has to bind toxins, its powdered seeds are used in parts of Africa to purify water. It therefore offers a natural alternative to the artificial purifying agents used industrially for water purification. It's time we Indians remember all of this and plant our very own Moringa wherever possible, in our farms, in our backyard, or even in a big pot.